To get us started, in this video, I'll review some of the basic ideas of scaling that we talked about in the very beginning of the course, and I'll introduce a little bit of terminology as well. So remember that the idea behind scaling, and really the idea behind this entire course, is to look at how properties of objects change when the size of the object changes. So for an example, suppose we have some shape, and this is, who knows, some three-dimensional blob thing. And then if I were to scale this up, so the idea is that the picture on the right is the same as on the left, it's just two times larger. Obviously, this is not a perfect drawing, but that's just sort of the idea. And we want to know, how might properties of this shape change when this happens? So by 2x here, I mean this is two times larger. It's two times larger in this direction, and in that direction. All right, so suppose in particular that we're interested in the volume. How would the volume of this shape change? Well, volume scales with length cubed. So I would write that volume scales as length cubed. So what this means is that if I were to double L, V goes up by not 2, not 4, but 2 cubed equals 8 times. So this shape has a volume 8 times larger than this shape. And so we've seen that sort of relationship when we've been thinking about dimension, right? The dimension, the exponent, that's been sort of the interesting thing. That's been the dimension when we're looking at self-similarity and so on. And this relationship here, I might write out by saying that V is proportional to L cubed. So V is proportional to L cubed. And so what that means is that they rise and fall in proportion to each other. If L cubed doubles, V will double. If V goes down by a third, L cubed must go down by a third. So that these two quantities are in proportion to each other. And that will be written mathematically. I'll just write this again. V equals KL cubed. And so K here is some constant. It would be different for different shapes. If it was a sphere, it would have one form. If it was a cube, it would have some other form. Who knows what that number would be for this shape. But there would still be some L cubed dependence, where L would be some length. Could be the height, could be this radius or something. This is also sometimes written, so you'd read that V is proportional to L cubed. I kind of prefer this notation, but this is certainly common. And then this is how one would say this. So V is proportional to L cubed. Let's think about some other properties. Suppose I was interested in the surface area. Well, it's an area, so we know that it's two-dimensional. So that's going to be proportional to L squared. It's two-dimensional. And then if I maybe wanted to look at, say, the height, to this, that's going to be proportional just to L, right? Height is one dimensional, and L is the same as L to the one. Notice that I haven't specified deliberately what L is here. L is just some length. It could be this length. Again, it could be this length. It could be that length. The main thing is we're establishing a relationship between a linear dimension, a length, and either surface area or height or volume. So again, volume scales as L cubed is proportional to L cubed. Surface area, or any area, is proportional to L squared, and height is proportional to just simply L. So in the next quiz, if you're feeling rusty with these ideas, you can practice this, and then we'll start thinking about scaling in the context of metabolic systems.